Sarah Palin's Army veteran son was just arrested in Alaska, here's what we know so far. Sarah Palin's oldest son Track, who is a veteran of the Iraq War, has been arrested in Wasilla, Alaska, where his mother once served as mayor. While many of the circumstances surrounding the incident remain a mystery, here is what we know so far. On Saturday, Track Palin was arrested in Wasilla on burglary and assault charges related to a domestic violence incident. He also faces a misdemeanor criminal mischief charge for causing nearly $1,000 in property damage. The victim in the case has not been identified, and Wasilla police have not released any further information in Track's case at this time. Court records show the son of former Alaska Governor Sarah Palin has been arraigned on three charges Sunday morning, all are domestic violence related. Track Palin, 28, faces a Class B felony charge of first-degree burglary, one charge of assault in the fourth degree and one charge of criminal mischief in the fourth degree. According to an online offender locator database, a Track Palin is listed in custody at Motsu Pretrial Facility. Court view shows, the offenses were all committed on Saturday, December 16. Palin was arraigned in the Palmer Courthouse at 10 a.m., Sunday morning. Source, 2. Attorney John Timison, who said he represents Sarah and Todd Palin, released a statement on their behalf on Sunday afternoon. Given the nature of actions addressed last night by law enforcement and the charges involved, the Palins are unable to comment further, the statement said. They ask that the family's privacy is respected during this challenging situation, just as others dealing with a struggling family member would also request. This is not the first time that Track has had a run-in with the law. He was also arrested in 2015 for domestic violence, and before that, he was involved in a brawl at a house party in 2014. Track Palin, 26, was arrested Monday, January 18, 2016, in Wasilla, Alaska after he allegedly slugged his girlfriend in the face, kicked her in the knee, and threatened suicide with an AR-15 assault rifle. He was charged with interfering with a report of domestic violence, possession of a firearm while intoxicated and assault. This was not Track Palin's first brush with the law. Back in 2014 he was involved in a wild brawl and a house party in Anchorage, during which his sister Bristol allegedly punched the host repeatedly in the face. No arrests were made and no charges were filed. Source, MSNBC. Track served in Iraq with the Alaska-based 25th Infantry Division's 1st Striker Brigade Combat Team for 1 year in 2008. Sarah Palin, the vice presidential candidate alongside Senator John McCain in 2008, took heat after the arrest for seemingly saying President Barack Obama was at fault for her son's issues following his service in the Iraq War, according to Fox News. My son, like so many others, they come back a bit different. They come back hardened, Sarah Palin said in 2008. They come back wondering if there is that respect for what it is that their fellow soldiers and airmen and every other member of the military have sacrificially given to this country, and that starts at the top. She added that military members look to Obama and question whether he knows the sacrifices they make to secure America and to secure freedoms. Palin was arrested after a domestic violence dispute with his ex-girlfriend, Jordan Loewe, in January 2016. He drunkenly punched and kicked her before threatening to take his own life, according to a police report. A police officer found Loewe hiding under the bed after she called 911, documents show. Charges of assault and interfering with a police report were dismissed, but Palin pleaded guilty to brandishing a weapon. Palin's firebrand mom said the arrest stemmed from post-traumatic stress disorder due to his military service. Source, Daily News. Track Palin remains in custody at the Motsu Pretrial Facility. Please keep the entire Palin family in your thoughts and prayers as they navigate through this difficult situation. These matters are trying for anyone, but enduring them in the public eye only magnifies what is already a tough situation. We would all do well to resist passing judgment until more information pertaining to this case is released.